Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is a challenging question. Factoring x+1 to the power 4 plus x+3 to the power 4 minus 272. In general, how to solve this kind of question? Look at this polynomial. Power 4 here is high. We need to simplify this. And the second part, you also need to simplify. How to simplify? We may use the binomial formula to simplify the first term and the second term. Then use the typical idea, grouping or long division. For both methods, we do need to know at least one of the zeros of this polynomial. Because the higher power is not very easy for us to see zeros. So that is why this question is challenging. So here we are going to use a different method, which is a shortcut. You will see why this method is good. Here, look at x+1, x+2. We have a number in between. We can see that that's the average of the two numbers, which is x+2. x+2, comparing with x+1, this one is just one number less. x+3 is just one number more. This is a typical method in algebra to simplify expressions to find the solutions or factoring. After we define y equals x+2, we can replace here x+1, x+3 in terms of y. If x+2 is y, x+1 should be y minus 1. x+3 should be y plus 1. This is the original polynomial. We replace x+1 by y minus 1. Replace x+3 with y plus 1. Right now, you still don't see why this method is good. Binomial formula. For y minus 1 to the power 4, we use the second formula here, minus, minus, minus here. For y plus 1 to the power 4, we have top formula. Now the good thing you can see now, we need to consider the sum of the first two. Y to the power 4, you have for the first one, you also have for the second one. y to the power 3 times 4, the second term. One is positive from here, one is negative. If we sum of those two, positive one, negative one, should be cancel each other. And for the third term, you have 6y squared from the first term, 6y squared from second term. You can add them together. And for this term, negative 4y from first term, positive 4y from second term. If we sum of the two, this 4y term will be disappeared. Back to this. So here, first term, we have y to the power 4 from here, y to the power 4 here, that's double. So for the 6y, for the same reason, we have double, 12y squared. So for this term, they cancel each other. One is positive, one is negative. For this, cancel each other. We only have a last one. Last one, you have one from the first one, one from the second one, should be 2. Simplify, negative 272 plus 2 will be negative 270. So here, all even numbers, we can factor 2 out. 2 out, then we have y to the power 4. Rewrite y to the power 4 as y squared, then squared. Then plus 6y squared, then minus 135. So here, if we consider y squared as only one variable, like a w, that's w squared plus 6w minus 135, we can use the quadratic formula. You can see that's w minus 9, w plus 15. We can continue to factor the first one, y squared minus 9, which is y minus 3 times y plus 3. So here, because that's plus, we cannot go further if we consider integer numbers, a factorization. So we're here, looks like we cannot continue to factor this polynomial. So what is y? Y, we know that's x plus 2. We need to replace y back here in terms of x. So replace y by x plus 2. X plus 2, x plus 2, here x plus 2 squared. Continue to simplify. You will see 2 minus 3 is negative 1. 2 plus 3 is 5. Then here, that's 4 plus 15 is 19. That's 19. Here should be an equal sign here. Equal sign. Now, conclusion. Original polynomial equals this. So here, what is the beauty part for this idea? In general, we have difficult time to find the zeros, to find the first factor. If we can find the first factor, the power can be reduced to 3, then maybe it's easy to solve the remaining question. If we cannot find a single factor, we cannot do grouping or long division to reduce the degree to a lower degree. It's a general idea. Here, the good idea is what? If we define the y variable in between the two items, then use the polynomial formula. We can cancel some items. Then we are here. Consider 2 to the power 4 still, that's a quadratic equation. We consider y squared as one variable. Then we can simplify it. Use the quadratic formula. After we simplify, we can easily simplify the first factor. So here, then we can replace y back into x terms. So we find the final answer. This way is not a typical way, it's a special way. When in the future you see similar problem, you may try this kind of idea. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.